In Core Animation and SwiftUI, you can add multiple animations on a view in order to animate different properties on the view. For example, in this animation, we are going to take a look at the third car over here. When we go to the code, you can see it has multiple animations. The first one is move, that propels the car from point B to point A. We also have fade out animation on the same car, that is over here. Since we have multiple animations on the car, we can control the individual animations, move and fade out separately. If we want the move animation to last longer, we can change its duration from 1 to, for example, 6 seconds. You can now see the move animation will take very long to start. And this animation, that is the fade out, starts faster than the move animation. Let's change it to, for example, 0.5. That will make the animation have a shorter lifetime. I will press Command Z to change it back to as it was. We can also change the other individual animation on the group, that is the fade out animation. So when we want the fade out animation to last longer, we can also change the duration from 1 to, for example, 6. And as the car moves from B to point A, you can see it doesn't even reach point A and disappears. Let's change the duration of the fade out animation to 0.5. So now the car disappears without even moving from point B to point A. I'm going to press Command Z to undo the change. To control the individual animations of the multiple animations on the view separately, that is easy. What we can't do is to control the duration of the move animation and the fade out animation together. Enter group animation in SwiftUI. We can use the duration of group animation to clip the duration of the individual animations in a group. So let's see how this works visually using Kite. I have the same car icon in Kite. To create group animation, I'll press Ctrl and click and choose the option Insert. I will go to the section Animations and choose Group Animation. When we go to the layer list, you can see we have group animation added to the view. Let's click here to expand. We have two animations created automatically, transform and anchor point. But this is not what we want. So let's double click on the first one and change it to move. We are going to change the second one to fade out. For the move animation, we are going to animate position, but here it is set to rotation. So let's change the property and go to position. Let's choose the X position because we are going to move it from here to the left. Since we don't know the exact position we want to move the car to, I'm going to select the car and go to the X position. You can see it is over here. If I drag the slider to the left, let's move it to somewhere here, that is 97.5. I will press Command and Z to undo the change, so I'm going to select the move animation again. I will leave the from value as it is and change the to value to 97.5. Let's also change the animation type from spring animation to basic animation. Let's go to the next animation, that is fade out. The animation type is already set to basic animation. Let's change the property from anchor point. For the fade out animation, we are going to use opacity. For the from value, let's set it to 1. And the to value, we are going to set it to 0, that is 0 opacity. From the timeline, I'm going to make the fade out animation to have the same duration as the move animation. So when I drag the playhead, to the right, you can see the car moves from right to left, and as it moves, it also disappears with the fade out animation. We can also preview the animation by clicking on the play icon. So this is how to create group animation in Kite. From the timeline, we can adjust the duration of the group animation as well as the individual animations in the group. For example, we can change the fade out animation to last shorter if I move it here. So if I move the playhead from the left to right, the fade out will happen faster than the move animation. We can also click here and adjust the length of the duration of the move animation as well to last even shorter than the fade out animation. So if I move this from here to the right, you can see the move animation happens faster than the fade out animation. That is how to control the individual animations in the group. But we can use the duration of the animation group to control both animations together. You can see here, we have this bar. That is the length of the duration of the group animation. So we have the group animation lasting for 2 seconds. Now, when we change the fade out animation to more than 2 seconds, for example, this way, the fade out animation is going to be clipped to the group animation duration, that is 2 seconds. Although we have the fade out animation to be 3 seconds. Let's preview. When it gets here, it will disappear. So the same with the move animation. Let's change this back to 2 seconds. And change the move animation to, for example, 4 seconds. When we preview, the group animation duration is still going to clip the move animation duration, although the move animation is set to 4 seconds. Half of the animation will be clipped. So when it gets to 2 seconds, the car will be already at the left position. So in Core Animation and SwiftUI, we use an animation group to control the duration of individual animations in a group or multiple animations on a view. In the beginning of this video, I showed how to control the individual animations of the multiple animations on this car. We can now add group animation to control the move and fade out animations on the car. Over here, I'm going to remove the comment. And this serves as the group animation on the car. Over here, it is already set to 12. So this is going to control both the move and the fade out animations. When we change the duration of the group animation to, for example, 0.5, that will make both animations happen faster. Let's change it to, for example, 24. Now, the animation will take very long time before the car moves from point B to point A and before the car disappears. So this is how group animation works in SwiftUI. We can use the duration of an animation group in SwiftUI and Core Animation to control the individual animations in the group. So if you have multiple animations on the same view, we can use group animation to shorten all the individual animations on the group or make the duration of the individual animations on the group last longer.